Dear students,
in this class we have to discuss another type of projection of lines. That means that our line is placed inclined to HP and parallel to VP. That is the present problem. Here this figure shows an isometric representation of first angle projection. That means this is the figure of first quadrant. Here our object is a line which is placed inclined to HP. From this figure we can understand that this is our HP horizontal plane. According to this plane we can say that our line AB is our object which is placed 45 degree to the horizontal plane. And we know that a line having minimum two points, here that point is A and B. Here B is the lowest point. Here B is not touched with HP. So we can say that point B is 10 mm above HP and 10 mm in front of VP. Similarly, point A is fixed 10 mm in front of VP. That is our question. From this picturization, we can formulate a question. That means a line AB, our object is a line, its name is AB, having 50 mm length. AB length of AB length of line AB is equal to 50 mm. That means AB is 50 mm. Length is placed 45 degree with respect to HP. 45 degree with respect to HP. And point B, here this is the point B, is 10 mm in front of VP. This plane is called VP. So this point is placed in front of VP by keeping 10 mm distance. And 10 mm and point B also 10 mm above HP. This is HP. So this point is placed 10 mm above HP. From this dimension we can understand that point A and point B is equally placed in front of the VP. So that value is 10 mm. So we can say that AB is parallel to VP. AB is parallel, line AB is parallel to VP and placed 45 degree inclined to the HP. So our question is, line AB 50 mm length is placed 45 degree to HP and point B is 10 mm in front of VP and 10 mm above HP and line AB is parallel to VP. Draw its projection. For the second figure shows an imagination of projection. Imagination of projection. Here, first we have to fix the position of the observer. First we have to draw its front view. For that, we have placed the position of observer. This symbol shows position of the observer. From this direction, he can see that clearly, he can see that its front view. That means, from this direction, he can project point A and B with respect to on its corresponding plane. We know that the front view projected on vertical plane. So keeping this distance, that means keeping 10 mm distance from vertical plane and keeping 45 degree angle, we can project point B and point A on its corresponding plane VP, keeping this 10 mm height and 45 degree angle. We have to project point A and B. When we have to project B, then B become B dash. B become B dash. So we know that this is XY line. This is reference line. This is reference line. Keeping 10 mm distance from reference line, 10 mm distance from reference line, this distance is 10 mm. 10 mm distance from reference line, we have put a point here. That point name is B dash. B dash. Now place your protractor here and keeping 45 degree, draw a inclined line through this 45 degree. Through this 45 degree. And take compass, your compass, and place the compass point on B dash and draw an arc here. Draw an arc here having a radius 50 mm. Keeping 50 mm radius, draw an arc here. That arc intersect the inclined line here. That intersecting point is marked as A dash. That means by keeping this 45 degree angle, we have to project point A with respect to vertical plane. Then we have to get a point here. That point is marked as A dash. Now connecting A dash B dash, we have to get a inclined line. Its angle is 45 degree. That is our front view. Next, we have to project its plan. For projecting its plan, the observer comes top side looking from here. He can definitely see that the line AB is placed parallel to with respect to vertical plane, keeping 10 mm distance. So he can project each point A and B with respect to its corresponding plane, horizontal plane. Corresponding plane, that's name is horizontal plane. Then he have to project A towards horizontal plane. Then we have to get a point here. That point is called A. Similarly, he have to project point B. Then B become small letter B, keeping this 10 mm distance. 10 mm distance. That means keep with respect to reference line, keeping 10 mm distance, you have to project point A and point B on its reference plane, on its horizontal plane. Then we have to get its plan. This is our plan. Now finally, this is the answer part. This one is the answer part. For answer part, first you have to draw XY line. XY line. Now in answer part, first you have to draw XY line. Now we have to project its plane, project its front view and plan on its reference plane. We know that in the case of first angle projection, the above XY line, that plane is called vertical plane, and below XY line, that plane is called horizontal plane. Now we have to project its front view. For projecting its front view, first we have to mark this height. That means from the horizontal plane, keeping 10 mm distance from the horizontal plane, the point is here. Point is here. Now first we have to draw XY line. From that, put a point here, keeping 10 mm distance. Put a point here. That point is called B. B dash. Now place your protractor. Protractor here. Place your protractor here. From that, we have to mark its inclination. Inclination angle is 45 degree. So by the help of this protractor, we can mark 45 degree. Through this 45 degree, we can draw a inclined line. Inclined line. Inclined line. Now take length of line AB in your compass. Take a radius, keeping 50 mm radius in your compass. Draw an arc here. That means keeping B as center, draw an arc here. That arc value is 50 mm. Now draw an arc here. That arc radius is 50 mm. This intersecting point is marked as A dash. A dash. Now this is our front view. This is our front view. Keeping 10 mm distance from reference line. 10 mm distance from 10 mm distance from reference line. The point B is marked here. That is B dash, and this angle is 45 degree, and this length is 50 mm. Now, next step is draw its plan. For projecting its plan on HP, have a definite steps. For that, you getting a plan. First, you have to project the point A towards in the downward direction. That means draw a vertical projector in downward direction, and that point extend up to that line, extend up to 10 mm distance, because our line AB is inclined 45 degree, keeping 10 mm distance in front of the vertical plane. So we have to project this extension line, projection line, extend up to 10 mm below the XY line. Now this point become B and this point become A. Now joining both these points by a straight line. Now this is our plan. This is our plan. This is our front view. Front view. This is our answer. Okay. Now listen here. First, in our real answer part, first we have to draw XY line. This is our reference line. Now, keeping 10 mm distance above HP. That means, keeping 10 mm distance from reference line, you have to put a point here. Put a point here. That point name is B dash. Now, draw a smooth horizontal line parallel to reference line. Now we have to place your protractor at point B and mark 45 degree here. Through this 45 degree, draw an inclined line. Draw an inclined line. Now take your compass. Take your compass and draw a arc with radius 50 mm. Take your compass and draw an arc with radius 50 mm. Now with the help of your compass, take 50 mm radius in your compass. Keeping B as center, you have to draw an arc here. Arc here, keeping 50 mm. And this intersecting point is called, this intersecting point is called A dash. A dash. Now you have to get our front view. Front view. That means our line AB is placed 45 degree with respect to HP, and our length of line AB is also given. That value is 50 mm. 50 mm. This is 50, and point B is 10 mm above HP. Now point B is 10 mm above HP. Now our front view is completed. This is front view. Now we have to draw its plan. For draw its plan, we have to project each point. That means draw a vertical projector downward in downward direction from the point A dash and B dash, we have to draw a vertical projector. That vertical projector touch, now it's touch on XY line, reference line. Now we have to extend that line at a distance 10 mm, because we know that our line AB is 10 mm placed 10 mm in front of vertical plane. So we have to project this extension line, extend up to 10 mm on the XY line. Now this point become, this point is marked as B and this point is called A. Now you have to connect both the points using a straight line, using a straight line. Now this is our plan, this is our plan, and we know that our object is placed 10 mm in front of vertical plane. So this value also 10 mm. Now in the case of a line which is inclined to HP and parallel to VP, front view, in our front view, the line is inclined with respect to HP, and in our plan we have to get a straight line. That means in our front view we have to get an inclined line, whereas in our plan we have to get a straight line. Okay,